to answer your question, it is worth it to mine because you're going to be making money.
Let us go to moon.
Yo, 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 what's up, everyone? Okay, so this section is called GPU profits as of today. And today's date is January 31st of 2021, and the price of Ethereum is around $1,315.40. Okay, so if you did want to check out the difficulty chart, we're about 4,449.903 terahashes. And really quickly checking out the block rewards, we're averaging around 3 to 4 Ethereum per block reward. Okay, so now to go over this, this is of course the GPUs, on top is the AMD, on bottom is Nvidia. This is the MSRP. This is what the graphics cards are mining, which is Ethereum. This is your hash rates you're getting for each GPU. This is how much power the GPUs are pulling. This is your efficiency, which is the hash rate divided by the wattage. This is how much you were making last week before electricity per day. This is how much you're making this week before electricity per day. This is my electricity cost, which I do pay about 10 cents per kilowatt hours. And this is how much I'm earning per day after electricity cost. And this is the percentage change. And it looks like our profits did increase about 12 to 13%. Okay, so now going over the most popular GPU, starting on the AMD side, for the 570-580s, you should be earning around $2.57 a day before electricity. For the 5600 XTs, you should be earning around $3.53 a day before electricity. For the 5700 XT, you should be earning around $4.86 a day before electricity. And for the Radeon 7, you should be earning around $7.80 a day before electricity. Now for the NVIDIA cards, starting with the 1660 Super, you should be earning around $2.60 a day before electricity. For the 2080 Ti, you should be earning around $4.93 a day before electricity. And checking out the new RTX cards, for the RTX 3070, you should be earning around $5.36 a day before electricity. For the RTX 3070, you should be earning around $5.45 a day before electricity. For the RTX 3080, you should be earning around $8.64 a day before electricity. And last but not least, for the RTX 3090, you should be earning around $10.80 a day before electricity. And then if you did scroll down a little bit, you'll see the overclocks I use for each GPUs. And this side is the NVIDIA side, and this side is AMD side. But just beware, every graphics card is silicon lottery, and my overclocks may not work with your overclocks. So if the card does crash, you do want to reduce your overclocks. And I did want to mention that I did add a couple other things here. So over here, this is the price of the GPUs I would personally shoot for. Now these prices may be different from what you shoot for, but I personally live in the US, so these are typically US prices. Right next to it is the MSRP if you wanted to compare. And I did add this one last section here, which is the hash rate, which one more time. But this is the worst case scenario. It's silicon lottery, so sometimes your GPUs just can't get that much hash rates, so this should help for the worst case scenario. But overall, it looks like our percentage change did increase about 12 to 13%, and the reason why more than likely is because the price of Ethereum went up, and of course we are still earning more than average when it comes to the block rewards. But let me know your thoughts. One other thing I do want to mention is on the bottom of this Excel, you'll see sheet 2 and sheet 1. If you click on sheet 1, this will give you the previous week's history if you want to check that out and compare. And if you do want to check out this Excel sheet, definitely join the Discord. Unfortunately, since there are a lot of scammers and bots out there, I do have to up the security in my Discord. So what you want to do is you do have to verify first. It's a quick CAPTCHA verification. And then once you verify, rules will appear. Once you're at the rules section, you want to scroll down until you see this green check mark. And once you click on this green check mark, you will have access to the full Discord. Once you get access to the full Discord, scroll all the way down. You will see weekly mining payout Excels, and it'll be this chart right here. Is it okay to mine ETH and XMR at the same time? Yes, it is possible. Your computer is going to run extremely slow. This is, would you use a 3060 Ti? I mean, yeah. Don't get me wrong. Any graphics card you own right now, it's going to be profitable. Even the non 4 gigabyte cards are profitable right now, which is crazy. So if I pull up what to mine, any card you have is profitable. Even if you're paying like 30 cents, it's profitable. The prices right now are crazy. Yeah, see, even after electricity, you've been paying 30 cents and this is like crazy high, but look, you're still super profitable. That's how crazy like mining is right now. To answer your question, it is worth it to mine because you're going to be making money. So, and the thing about GPU mining or even just any cryptocurrency mining, even Bitcoin mining, just be aware it's supposed to be passive income, meaning that you shouldn't have to worry about it. I mean, I know a lot of people are worrying about it because people are in debt. People spend money just being in debt. And I highly recommend do not be in debt. But I understand people will do what they want to do. People are gamblers. People are willing to take this bet. I'm just not like a big time gambler. So I wouldn't take this bet. It's just risky. Because truth be told, if you want more Ethereum, how do you think a lot of people got more Ethereum compared to profits? You kind of want the prices to go down. You kind of want it not to be profitable anymore so people stop mining. So that's pretty much how you want to earn more Ethereum. Just be aware, when Ethereum is profitable, more people will jump in. So it's like a double-edged sword. It says if we're lucky, prices will crash so we can accumulate more. Yeah, that's a trade-off. So either you want more Ethereum or you want more profits. Because if you want more Ethereum, you want the price to crash. And you know, in order for less people to mine, you want the profits to go down. So if the profits go down, less people will mine. And then personally, you'll gain Ethereum. I'm earning less, but since the price of Ethereum is like 1300, like, you know, four times the price where it was before, that's the reason I'm making money now. So yeah, it kind of works both ways. I used to mine Ravencoin like a lot, and I still have a lot of Ravencoin. I stopped, obviously, because why would you mine Ravencoin when you could make $5 compared to $1? Why? I'm automatically earning five times. If you can mine Ethereum, just mine Ethereum. And you can just trade. Yes, the fees may be out there with trading fees and it may take some time, but five times. You're making five times as worth it. Maybe do those extra steps to get Ravencoin because five times. You're earning five times worth. Now, I always mention if you're earning maybe like 5% more. Let's say Ethereum is at $1.20 and Ravencoin is $1. Then yes, it may not be worth it to mine Ethereum and do all the trade because time. And in the end, it may even out to be the same. But in this case, let me repeat, five times profit. Just mine Ethereum and then just trade for now. Now, down the road, it could be different. If these numbers are closer, then yes, mine whatever coin you want. But just logically, just mine Ethereum. Macadon says, hi, are you mining green coin for some reason? Oh, no, I'm not mining green coin. I'm just mining Ethereum. Back in the day, back in the bear market, back when we were just sideways, just beware, Ethereum was not the number one coin. So yes, back in the day, I was mining Ethereum, Ravencoin, and Grincoin. But I was trading it majority back to BTC. Back in 2018, 19, Ethereum was not the number one coin to mine. It was either Ravencoin or Grincoin or Beamcoin. So those three coins were higher than Ethereum. So just be aware, back in 2018, Ethereum wasn't number one. It was either Grincoin, Beamcoin, or Ravencoin. So that's why I didn't mine those three coins. This is how do you switch your ETH to BTC? Trade. I use an exchange. I'm currently mining ETH only. Nice. ETH is good. I mean, ETH is the only coin you should be mining right now. Just be aware, the whole Tether thing could just be FUD right now, just so they could hash it a little bit so people can buy in cheaper. So it could be just FUD. Matrix Hyper says, how do you mine? Join my Discord. I have a bunch of guides here. A lot of people have guides, so you can actually just YouTube any guide. I have my own guide though. So if you want to check out my guide, I think my guide's pretty good. Self-promote real quickly. But everyone's guides are pretty good. But I have my own guide right here. Check out my Discord. This will teach you how to mine Ethereum. But if you want simple, no work, do nothing, NiceHash is typically the best way to go. Now I know NiceHash had their history, but they proved their point by now. Or they should have proved their point by now. But yeah, definitely check out my Discord. If you have specific questions, let me know. Would you recommend double mining or is it not worth it? Double mining? What do you mean double mining? Oh, are you talking about dual mining? Like mining Ethereum and another coin? It's not worth it. Just let you know right now, it's not worth it. You're going to use more power and you're going to lose some hash rate for Ethereum. It's better if you just mine Ethereum straight. You're just going to make more. He is saying is that you should buy Ethereum directly. Right now, hardware is too expensive. It depends. So yes, right now, if you're trying to buy hardware for scalper prices, they're expensive. But like I mentioned, if you can find it, I'm more of a miner than a buying the coin. So I personally would mine. So yes, do not buy scalper prices. But like I mentioned, if you can find it right here, you know, do work, wait in line, go to Micro Center, go to your local game store or computer store and just work. Like any job, you have to work to get money. But yeah, do not buy it for scalper prices. Is it a special computer required to mine or is it a standard computer? It depends. So if you're trying to mine Bitcoin, if you want something super easy, don't care about the noise. If you have a factory, you know, simple plug and play, no work, just plug and play. It's just you need money. Buy ASICs. If you have tons of money, don't want to do any work. This is only if you have like a facility though. If you're willing to spend a lot of money, like 200,000 plus, But like I mentioned, that's money. Then stick with ASICs because you don't have to worry about the maintenance. Because I believe GPU mining is more of a hobby mining thing. And it should stick with hobby mining. So that's what I'm saying. Anything business related, like if you're trying to go super big, stick with ASICs. It's just easier, less worrying, and plug and play. The main thing is plug and play because you're going to have a bunch of miners. Because if you go GPU and if you spend $500,000, you better have someone that knows what they're doing working for you. Because if you don't know what you're doing, you're going to have issues straight up. But you know, if you're trying to spend less than $100,000, then GPUs are the way to go typically. But you're right. If you spend a lot of money, go ASICs. If you spend less than $100,000, go GPUs. Just because you'll probably earn more money. Oh, if you just want to get into a hobby, if you have a gaming computer, just mine on your gaming computer. No need to buy new equipment. Just use the equipment you have right now. That's what I recommend. So you can start. How much do I need to invest? Wait, are you talking about how much to invest into Bitcoin? Yeah, I would just invest with extra money. Don't invest money that you need. Because of course, if you need the money, you should use that for what it's needed for, like food or shelter. But right, only invest money you're willing to lose. Because think of this as like a savings stocks account. It's not really a savings account. It's not really stocks because it's crypto. But think of this as something where you can put money away and then don't need to worry about it down the road. Because the name of the game is to hold. So the longer you hold, the better success you should have. So what I always recommend is lock it up, hold, and come back when you need it. Oh, crypto in Africa is good for people. Definitely. I think crypto everywhere is good. What are the GPU miner's lifetime approximately? Hopefully 10 years or hopefully 5+ years, right? Let's Google search. 5 to 10 years. Trust me, playing video games on a graphics cards and mining is no different. With mining, you're actually undervolting using less heat and less power majority of the time. So it should last you the same time as gaming. So 5 to 10 years. I mean, I had my 1070 for over 4 years now and they're still running perfectly fine. So, and I already broke even. And I'm hoping it lasts for 10 years. But yeah, 5 to 10 years. Mining, non-mining in general, 5 to 10 years. What is the best crypto miner in your opinion? Oh, so I have a whole guide for that if you want to check this out on Discord. So this is basically what I do for every single mining rig. Just go right here, mining guide. It'll be right here, how to mine Ethereum. Which wallet do you use? Is it safe to use Binance for a wallet so I can trade to other coins for low fees? You can. If you don't have a lot of coins, just beware. Anytime you put your coins on an exchange, you have no control. If the exchanges go down, you're stuck. You can't move it. You can't touch it. Not your keys, not your wallet. That's a common phrase in crypto. You can, but it's always highly recommend to put it in a wallet. But you know, if you're a trader, then you need to trade. So you need to put it on exchange. Hello, do you think it's a good time to buy GPUs for Ethereum mining? What about ETH moving to POS? So POS is could be a couple of years. So more than likely, well, hopefully people will break even by then. So that's the plan. So your main goal right now is just to break even. Well, in any investment, you want to break even. So your main goal for anyone is just to break even. So if you have to sell every week, go for it. Just break even. Because I mentioned this before, once you break even, you have more peace of mind. You don't worry as much. Because since I broke even on every rig, I don't really care if a mining rig goes down. I mean, yes, I'm losing a little bit of money, but I broke even. So yes, break even. First thing, once you break even, you don't worry as much and you will enjoy crypto a little bit more. Now, if this is a good time, like I mentioned, it's only a good time if you can buy it for MSRP. If you can't buy it for MSRP, it may be best to wait until you can buy it. Now, some people think that it's, like I mentioned, it's still worth it buying it the scalper prices. I personally will not buy it at scalper price, and I recommend not to because, like I mentioned, you do not want to support the scalpers. Do you think it's viable to start mining now? I got 2 spare GPUs. I always mention if you have the parts laying around, then yes, you're not spending any extra money. So just beware, you're not spending any extra money. This is money that you're just earning. So yes, it is worth it. You're just earning money. If you have it lying around, if you have it already. Now, if you have to buy hardware, so this is what people need to get understand. If you need to buy hardware, you have to do work. You have to find it. If you can get it at MSRP, it is worth it. If you can't, then it's not worth it. But in some people's eyes, it's still worth it. So that's up to you. But in my eyes, it's not worth it. Right, since you have 2 spare GPUs, like you're saying, and it's 3060 coming in a few weeks, definitely, yeah, just start mining. You already have the equipment. Is it a ginger move to make a 24-month interest-free loan and buy your cards and pay back with the mining revenue? That's the thing. You don't want to take that risk. That's like super risky. But that's the problem. Like, even though I say this, it don't matter what I say. People are going to do it. Don't go into debt for mining. That's what I typically say. Try not to be in debt for mining. Now, if it's like a couple thousand, that's fine. If it's 1,000, 2,000, that's fine. That should be okay. If you're spending like 20, 30, 50, $100,000 in debt for mining, don't do it. It's so risky. It's so much money to be in debt with. Now, if it's a couple thousand, that should be okay because You can sell your parts, eat ramen noodles for 1 month, you know, budget. You made a mistake. You lost a couple thousand, you know, budget yourself that $1,000. But, you know, 20,000, 50,000, just don't do it for that much money. It's just, I've seen so many people fail, especially once the profits don't come in. Like, people abandon ship way too quick. And it's like they have no choice. They have to abandon ship because they just can't pay for the electricity. And I know what I say, people are going to still spend, you know, 10, 20, 30, but I just highly recommend don't do that. Now, like I mentioned, 1,000, 2,000, that could be okay. And you can recover off, you know, a couple thousand, no problem. But once you hit the 10, 20, 30,000 debt range, it's so hard to recover and it's going to haunt you as well. So that's why I recommend don't do it if it's that much money. Just don't do it if it's that much money. Just don't be in debt. All right, so thanks for everyone who stopped by. I had a blast, and hopefully you guys had fun as well. But before I leave, let's throw some crazy effects. Let's throw some fire. Let's make it wavy. And let's do a barrel roll. But of course, go out there, keep grinding. Life of the Miner out.
Let's go, kill. She's a fiber wire, let's go. All right, so it does want me to go here.